everyone. So nice to see all of you here tonight. I'm Professor Kimberly Beasley. I am chair of the Department of Music here at Jacksonville University, and we welcome all of you to Terry Concert Hall tonight. Thank you for being here. It has been our pleasure and honor to host this season of the Ritz Chamber Players. The programming, as you all know, is amazing. The performing is amazing. And we have so much enjoyed this season having them in this hall. I would like to introduce to you Conchita Robinson, a member of the board on the Ritz Chamber Players, to have a few words.
Thank you so much. Good evening to each of you, and I am Conchita Robinson, and I'm so honored to be a member of the Ritz Chamber Players Board of Directors. It brings me great joy to extend a warm welcome to you this evening on behalf of the Ritz Chamber Players Board of Directors. Your presence at this performance is truly appreciated as we celebrate our 22nd year journey. Dedicated 22 years dedicated to fostering a more inclusive and diverse cultural community in Northeast Florida and beyond. A heartfelt thank you goes out to all of our supporters, including the RCMS Board of Directors, corporate and individual donors, friends, volunteers, and our exceptional Ritz Chamber Player artists. It is through the collective efforts of these individuals that we have been able to make these 22 years and tonight's performance possible. During intermission, we will invite you to join us for some birthday cake and refreshments provided by the Bowles City Chapter of the Lynx Incorporated. We extend our gratitude to the Bowles City Chapter of the Lynx, who have been steadfast supporters of the Ritz Chamber Players since our inception, enriching our journey in countless ways. We humbly ask for your continued support of the Ritz Chamber Players to help us sustain our mission and to continue providing free performances. Your donation this evening will play a vital role in ensuring that we can continue enriching lives through music for many, many more years. You can make a contribution by scanning the QR code in the program or by using the donor envelope that we have provided. Thank you so much for your generosity, and we hope you thoroughly enjoy tonight's performance. Thank you.
I'm one of the founding members of Ritz Chamber Players, so I was here 22 years ago. thank you. I appreciate you. we're happy to begin this program with the very last piece of music that Coleridge Taylor Perkinson wrote. It's four string trio. And he actually wrote it for Ritz Chamber Players. He only got to write a small portion of the movements that he wanted to, right? Cancer took him away from us, but we were so enriched by his work, by his character. He was our very first composer in residence here in Jacksonville. So he was with us here as well 22 years ago. Yeah. So we want to begin this program commemorating him along with the Ritz Chamber Players. The story goes that he heard Ritz Chamber Players play the Dolciani Trio, which is the last piece on your program tonight. And he was so inspired by that that he wanted to write us a string trio, and we're going to play this portion for you beginning our program. Thank you.
might not have heard of, but he was born in 1775, Swedish, Finnish heritage, and he was a clarinetist, and he was found out that at the time there was not a lot of works written for the instrument. The clarinet really was developed much later than these fine string instruments. I'm sure you've heard the like Stradivarius, those instruments which were made and perfected in 1650-ish, right? I have to check. But we were much later in joining the orchestra. So around the time of Haydn and Mozart is when the clarinet became a part of the orchestra. And Mozart was one of the first major composers to start writing specifically for the clarinet. But right around Mozart and pre-Mozart was Kreutzer, who wrote a lot of concertos for the clarinet and three works in this configuration. And this is his second quartet for clarinet. You say a clarinet quartet because this is a different combination than what you usually see. And we found them, we kind of discovered these things together. And we found them just really lovely. They're very, very light and very interesting. And I think you'll enjoy it. So continue to look up works of his and explore him more. I think he was a little more famous later while he was alive. But I'm so happy to have discovered these works and performed them with the chamber players. So enjoy. This is quartet number two. Thank you.
Thank you.
Carlos Simon's loop. Have you ever heard of the saying, thrown for a loop? Okay, well, this was composed in 2020 when we were all thrown for a loop. Okay. So he felt like the day in, day out of being in quarantine was like being in a loop. So this is what he wrote, Loop for String Trio.